Summer brought warmth and sunshine. Sadako seemed to be getting better. I'm over halfway to 1,000 cranes. I can just feel something good will happen. And it did. Her appetite came back, and much of the pain went away. To keep the magic working, she made more cranes. 544, 545. And soon it would be Obon, the biggest holiday of the year. Sadako would be allowed to spend the holiday at home. The house had been scrubbed and swept until it gleamed. The air was filled with the smells of Sadako's favorite foods. Obon was a special celebration for the spirits of the dead who returned to visit those they loved on Earth. Sadako helped her mother place dishes of bean cakes and rice balls on the altar shelf to nourish the returning spirits. It was good to be home. Perhaps, just perhaps, she was home to stay. Later, her mother stood in the doorway of her room and whispered the poem she used to say when Sadako was little. Oh, heavenly cranes, cover my child with your wings. The next day, Mrs. Asaki came out with something she had always wanted Sadako to have, a silk kimono. It's very beautiful, but why did you do it? I'll never be able to wear it, and silk is so expensive. Sadako-chan, your mother stayed up late last night to finish sewing it. Try it on for her. Sadako put on the kimono. Masahiro said she looked like a princess. Then Sadako's younger brother, Eiji, pulled out a crumpled piece of silver paper from his pocket and handed it to his sister. Here is for another crane. Sadako sniffed the paper. Smells like candy. I just hope the gods like chocolate. Everyone burst out laughing. It was the first time they'd all laughed together in months. With all the holiday excitement, Sadako grew pale and tired. And when the holiday passed, she was happy to be in the quiet of her hospital room. She brought back a gift from the bamboo class, a Kokeshi doll. Sadako kept it next to her, like a friend. Often, her thoughts turned to Kenji. What good was so much sickness? What good could she do? She remembered Peace Day and the bright paper lanterns floating on the river. She picked up the special crane she made the night Kenji died and decided to send it to the mayor. She looked at the paper bird and said, "I will write peace on your wings and you will fly all over the world." Fall came. Mrs. Sasaki was spending more time at the hospital. You'll be better soon, Sadako-chan. Maybe when the sun comes out again. But toward the end of October, Sadako grew weaker and started wondering. Does it hurt to die? Or is it like falling asleep? Still, she managed to fold more paper cranes. 643, 644. One day, Sadako drifted in and out of a strange half-sleep. When I die, I will live on a heavenly mountain and meet Kenji on a distant star island. Each time she opened her eyes, her family was still there. She could feel the presence of grandmother. She knew she was part of a warm, loving circle. Nothing could ever change that. She looked up at her cranes fluttering overhead. In the light autumn breeze, they seemed almost alive. How beautiful and free they are. Sadako closed her eyes for the last time.